Hey guys, it's Anna. So as you might have noticed, I have officially changed the name of my channel. So if you watched my previous video, you saw that I was thinking about it. I actually had been thinking about it before all the COPA craziness, because when I first started the channel, I was very focused on the travel agency and it being like my travel agency vlog. But as the months have kind of progressed, this has kind of turned more into like my personal channel, you know? And so that was one of the prompts, the COPA issue with you know, the family content also influenced that. So I had been thinking about changing my name before COPA Gate, but then when COPA Gate exploded, then I was definitely more encouraged. I mulled around a few names, and like some of them fit, some of them didn't fit. You know, I used to be really, like, I'm a big thing with domain names, but then, like, I looked at the name for the channel. If I ever get a domain name, it won't come cheap. But I figured, you know, a lot of YouTubers don't even have domain names. So because actually it's like $1,000 for this, because it has a really popular name. I don't know very many Annas, but then travel is also in the name, so apparently that's big bucks. So, but I feel like it's me, and I travel, so Anna Travels seemed to fit perfectly, and I wanted just to go over some things. I've been trying, I do a lot of things personally. I have another small business. I do the travel agency part-time, and I also run horse shows as a small hobby business, and then I have my main full-time job. So a lot of things, I've always been like this. I've always had like my mind going in 800 different places, but I've always managed it, sometimes more better than others. But it's just always how I've been. Like ever since I was 16, I've always had like one main job and like two other hobbies. And well, the travel agency isn't a hobby, but I'm serious about it. But it's just how my brain has always worked. I am condensing a little bit of on social media, so Anna's Magical Moments will still be my Instagram, but I'm concentrating more on like that for business. I really haven't seen that much growth in my travel agency business through Instagram. I know some agents have really good success with it. I don't know. One, it's like another thing for me to manage, and you know, mind you, I've not been as good about my Facebook travel agency page because of the wedding, and I'm purposely, I haven't taken on that many clients this year, well, especially later part of the year, because I knew that the wedding would make me crazy, and it has, and it was a good call. I really only have, I have one client traveling this weekend to Disney, who's my friend, and then I have one client that's traveling who is also like one of my good friends. He's pretty much coming to my wedding, and then they're flying down, and pretty much what we're doing, but and we're gonna go to Galaxy's Edge together. And then I have a client in January, and she already knows that I'm a little crazy right now, and she's like, whatever, have a good wedding and I'll send the final payment soon. And so it's been a little bit crazy, so I'm not creating Anna Travels on Instagram. One, there's apparently a few, and secondly, I'm just gonna do Kaiju Bites. That's my personal Instagram, and I know brand wise you should have all identicalness, but really it helps me, you know, have one Instagram account to deal with and then have my business Instagram just for business. And that's how it is. Facebook, I created a Facebook page, but I'm not gonna utilize it just yet. I haven't really felt like I get much traffic from Kaiju Bites to my Instagram, I mean to my YouTube channel. Sometimes like it does help for some people because it knows that I'm you know, released a new video. I will eventually start utilizing Anna Travels for Facebook, especially if I have a video that's deemed children, for children, I might post it up there. I created a group and I created a Facebook page, but I haven't decided what I'm going to utilize more. I haven't decided. you know, I'm not that big of a YouTuber, so I will just see what the progression is. And then again, so yeah, so if you want to message me, I mean, for the folks that have already, like, have some PMs going with, like exchanges and swap exchanges, that's fine. If you want to include me in any future swaps or want to tag me in anything, please use Kaiju Bytes. And yeah, so with that being said, we are at 201 subscriber. I had like 4 new subs today, which I was at 197 this morning. And then boom, I'm at 201. And thank you guys. Thank you so much for the support. I really appreciate it. I have a good hopes for the future despite Copagate. I'm cautiously optimistic that all this craziness will eventually die down and YouTube will continue to grow and evolve, and we just get this whole bad juju of the end of 2019 with YouTube over with, I hope. I don't really expect COPPA to the FTC to really do anything, especially because I don't work for a federal contractor, but I kind of am in the federal contracting world, and I know how the federal government works. December 7th or 10th is like the end of when they're hearing petitions and stuff like that. And some people have asked me, should they sign it? I'm like, absolutely. Tell them your story. Tell them what you use YouTube for. Tell them that family content, is important to you on YouTube, and that it's not your fault about the data that's being collected. You know, you're not the ones that's targeting the ads to children under the age of 13. And tell them your story. It doesn't, like, everybody has a voice. This is why the U.S. government, this is why America is great. We have a voice as citizens. And even if you're not an American citizen, if you use YouTube, sign the petition. You know, show the government how important YouTube is. I mean, I know some people are going crazy about storming the YouTube, like, headquarters and all this craziness. But, you know, honestly, it wouldn't be a bad idea if, like, there was a protest, you know, at FTC quarters in D.C. But, hey, I don't know. You know, show your support and show them how much YouTube family content means to you. And also, I'm excited for the future. I have lots of plans for 2020, and I want to bring you guys along. After our honeymoon, we get to go to Norway, and then after Norway, we're not sure. We do want to go to Japan in 2021, but we also need to be adults and, like, recover financially from the wedding. Like, we've paid everything out of pocket. So we just need to recover a little bit and actually, like, have a savings account again and look to our future, wherever that may be. But I do want to bring you guys along for our future adventures. So thank you guys again for the support. I am so excited for the future, and I'm going to be hopeful. I really am. I'm going to be super hopeful, and I can't wait to share the future with you guys. So until next time, welcome to Anna Travels, and I can't wait to show you stuff, and I hope you guys have a good day. Like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys around.